serve for tourism in the country. They serve tourism. And tell us, Minister, how do you feel about the official opening now of the Argyle International Airport?
Well, I think I am as excited as I was on the 14th of February. I was fortunate to be one of the passengers touching down in Cal just after 4 o'clock, and to be here at the terminal building again, this time in the departure lounge, seeing the departure lounge really buzzing with activity, filled with persons checking to go back out, families of those persons here milling around and socializing, everyone with a beam on their face from here to here. Another very proud moment for us as Vincentians. As Minister of Tourism, Sports and Culture, it's really my privilege and my pleasure to be here, to be part of this another historic moment where we checking in persons and flying back out of the country. And from all indications, for the rest of the year, especially come June, July, for our 40th anniversary of Vinci Mass, all indications are there that we will have a bumper crowd coming in for the
Cal. Right. Give us a little idea, because you say you came in on Cal on the 14th. What was the atmosphere like? The persons boarding and anticipating touching down at Argyle, being one of the first commercial passengers to touch down?
Well, it started up in the airport in New York, JFK, where, you know, persons were there, all excited. They gathered together for group photos. People were, you know, just talking very loud, sharing with persons from other countries who were inquiring, what is this all about? This is not the usual. So we were able to promote St. Vincent's and the Grenadines from that moment. When we got on the plane, the flight all the way down, we were busy all the time. Persons didn't have a chance to sleep. The air hostesses were very much involved in what was happening. As I indicated, they virtually became Vincentians for that 4-hour flight. And so much so that some of them have committed to come back for Easter this year. So we had the entire flight crew on board with what was happening. Now the approach to the Argyle International Airport, easily the most beautiful and exciting approach I've ever seen for going into any country. And you know, we were able to really savor that moment. There were wows, screams, shouts on the aircraft from Vincentians who know the island, but never saw it from that angle. And when we touched down, that is when everything, there was just an outburst of praise and delight at being home. And then when we came out of the building, well, the reception from immigration and customs, first class, when we saw the facility that we have here, second to none in the region, and when we came out and greeted by these thousands of persons who are out here for the program, I mean, words cannot explain. It just all came together in one happy lump. The excitement, pride of Vincentians, that here we are at last, at the moment that we've been dreaming for, we've been longing for, the opening of our own international airport, which will take away many of our problems, our troubles, our woes, getting to the destination. And most importantly, now we can really invite persons to our home, St. Vincent and the Grenadines. We have the most diverse tourism product. We have the warmest, most friendly people in the entire world. So now we have to build our room capacity and tell more and more persons, come to the destination, and then we can show.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Minister, for being with us.
Yes.
Have a good day.
My pleasure.